want to pick off from last Wednesday, amen, talking about the three important callings. There are different callings, various callings in the body of Christ, but we want to look at three tonight. We want to really focus on one, amen, because we hit the first two, amen, pretty hard. I want to build on that last one. But let's go to the Word of God first, amen. Let's go to, amen, Hebrews 3 and 1. You may have this. Let's read this and you have this. Wherefore, holy brethren, partakers of the what?
Heavenly calling, Lord.
Wherefore, holy brethren, partakers of the what?
Heavenly calling.
Consider the apostle and high priest of our profession, Christ Jesus. Amen. Go to, amen. Somebody say, heavenly calling.
Heavenly calling.
Go with me to 2 Timothy 1 and 9. And start, go to the verse before that. No. Okay, yeah, right here. Be not thou therefore ashamed of the testimony of our Lord, nor of me, his prisoner, but be thou partaker of the afflictions of the gospel according to the power of God, who have saved us. Y'all see that?
Amen.
And have called us with a what?
Holy calling.
Not according to our works, but according to his own purpose and grace, which was given us in Christ Jesus before the world began. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
You may have your seats. Amen. Praise God. Go with me to Philippians 3 and 14. I press toward the mark for the prize of the what?
High calling.
Of God in who?
Christ Jesus.
Here we see three different types of callings. Amen. Heavenly calling. Amen. Heavenly calling deals with what?
Salvation.
Amen. Heavenly calling deals with what?
Salvation.
Heavenly calling deals with what?
Salvation.
Amen. Heavenly call, amen, deals with salvation. God, I won't spend too much time on this. Heavenly call, we dealt with, was good last week, wasn't it? Did you get an understanding last week? Heavenly call deals with salvation. The heavenly call of salvation is an invitation. Amen. An invitation to salvation. Amen. Many are called, but few are what?
Chosen.
It's not God's will that any man perish, but all come to repentance. Not some, but all. And how do they come to repentance? By the heavenly call. Amen. What is the heavenly call? The gospel of Jesus Christ is the heavenly call. When you preach the gospel of Jesus Christ, whosoever hears the gospel of Jesus Christ, amen, they are a candidate for salvation. Amen.
Amen.
That is the invitation of God into the kingdom of God. Amen. So when you preach the gospel, what is the gospel? The death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. Who is a candidate? Who is validated to be a preacher? Everyone that's saved. Amen.
Amen.
If you are saved, you are a preacher. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
Don't necessarily mean you're a teacher. You're a preacher. Amen. And a preacher heralds the word of God. What is a herald? Something that you proclaim. What do we proclaim? The gospel. What is the gospel? The death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
So when you declare the gospel to someone that don't know Jesus, you preaching. Amen. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
That's good to know. Amen. How shall they call on him in whom they have not believed? And how shall they believe in him in whom they have not heard? And how shall they hear without a preacher? And how shall they preach except they be sent? Go preach, preacher. Oh, come on, somebody.
Amen.
You don't have to be behind a pulpit to preach. Come on, somebody. Anytime you talk about Jesus, you preaching, man. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Amen. Don't necessarily mean you're a teacher. A preacher. Come on, somebody. And we all are called to preach. Come on, somebody. Anytime you talk about Jesus, that's preaching.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And so that is the invitation, amen, to everyone. Now, everyone, to qualify, amen, for a heavenly call, you have to answer the call.
Amen.
Amen. And we found out that call means to make an appeal. Amen. An appeal is a request for help, support. I need help. Amen. Praise God. And when you make an appeal, it changes. But you don't like your verdict. Come on, somebody. A verdict is a judgment against you. And I don't like what you, I don't like that I'm put to death. I don't like that I'm a sinner. So I let me make an appeal to God. Come on, somebody. I'll confess Jesus Christ and change the verdict. Come on. An appeal, you appeal to a higher authority. And God is the higher authority. He the one that can change the verdict. Come on, somebody. Come on. If you don't like, amen, even in your jurisdiction, what the court is saying, you can appeal to a higher court. You can take it to the Supreme Court. So far, to the Supreme Court, if you don't like, amen, what the judge, what the verdict the judge gave you. Come on, somebody. Amen. If we have a verdict, amen, we can change our verdict. Come on, somebody. Just make an appeal to God. I'm not a sinner. I make an appeal to God. You're no longer a sinner. You're righteous. You're no longer dead. You're alive. Come on, somebody. God changes the verdict. So, amen. Say it again, boy. He sure can, man. And that's good to know. So, if you make an appeal to God, call him. That's the, to whosoever call. Who is whosoever?
Anybody.
Whosoever call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. My. Don't spend too much time. Heavenly call. Salvation. Amen.
Amen.
Many are called, but few are chosen. After you answer the call of salvation, then you move from salvation to separation. Come on, somebody. And that deals with holy calling.
Amen.
Are y'all with me? Holy calling deals with separation. Come out from among them and be ye what? Separate, saith the Lord, and I will what? Receive you. Come on, somebody. So we found out last week, holy, amen, we are people that are holy. Be ye holy, for I am holy. Come on, somebody. And so, amen, holy is not, oh, watch this, holy is being separated, it's being insulated, not isolated. Amen. Because, when you're holy, God separates you. When you become a Christian, now you need to be separated, insulated, not isolated. When something is insulated, it's like a wire, amen. A wire is insulated to keep electricity or keep things, water damage, some kind of damage. It keeps the contamination out. Come on, somebody. Amen. And you've been insulated with the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
To keep you from being contaminated from the things of the world.
Amen.
You're not going to be isolated from the world because you got to still what? Preach the gospel. Come on, somebody. But you're insulated from the world. You're no longer contaminated by the things of the world. Come on, that's good to know, man. Come on, somebody. That I'm not condemned. I'm overwhelmed. I'm not ruled or governed by the things of the world.
Amen.
I'm insulated.
Amen.
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 So we hit that last week. And then the last is the third, amen, is the me. I like that to say the best for last is what? High call. What is the high call?
Serving.
And God said, you need to hit that some more.
Amen.
Because you must be a servant. Serving is the highest call in the kingdom of God.
Amen.
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 Not your title. Serving. Can we hit some things?
Yes, sir.
Before I lay this out.
Yes, sir.
Go to Romans chapter 1. The high call, sir. Paul, what?
A servant
of Jesus Christ called to be what?
An apostle.
That's an office gift. Amen?
Amen.
Praise God. And that's a position of authority. Are y'all with me?
Amen.
But Paul said what he is first?
Servant.
A servant of Jesus Christ. Come on, somebody. And we got to learn how to serve before we're in authority.
Yes.
And we're going to look at scripture and we're going to back this up with scripture. But you must know how to serve first.
Amen.
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 Come with me to, hallelujah, go to James chapter 1. Read it. What does it say?
James, a servant of God and of the Lord Jesus Christ, to the 12 tribes who scattered abroad, greeting.
James, a what? A servant. Jude chapter 1. What does it say?
Jude,
a servant. Y'all see this? Mm-hmm. It's a servant first. We must learn how to serve.
Amen.
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 2 Peter chapter 1. Simon Peter, a what?
A servant.
And an apostle of Jesus Christ. What did he say first? Servant. Amen. You must serve first. Amen.
Amen.
Watch it. There's some other things I want to hear. Go to Ecclesiastes 9 and 10. Want to hit these? I'm going to get into this question. Come on, come on, come on. Whatsoever thy hand findeth what?
To do.
Do it with all what?
Might.
For there is no what?
Word.
Nor device, nor knowledge, nor wisdom in what?
Grace.
Whether thou goest. See, whatsoever you put your hands to right now, do it with all your might.
Amen.
And how do you do it? Serve.
Wow.
Huh?
That's cool.
Is this all right?
Amen.
Come with me to Luke 22. See, it's what I'm trying to get this in your spirit, because we need, God needs you. God wants you to serve first.
Amen.
Amen. Promotion don't come, yeah, it's quiet up in here, but that's all right. It gives me more time to speak.
Mm-hmm.
Promotion comes after you serve.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
If you don't know how to serve, in God's kingdom, it's not about your credentials.
No.
It's about your heart.
Amen.
Oh, come on, somebody.
Amen.
And too many of us, we self-serve instead of serve.
Right.
Well, come on, somebody. We seek for self-gratification. Come on, somebody. What's in it for me? Can I help you?
Yes, go ahead, sir.
Luke 22. Let's go to Luke 22 and 23, start at verse 23. Watch this. And they begin, the apostles, to inquire among themselves, Which of them it was should do this. Keep going. And there was also strife. Look at this.
Mm-hmm.
Self-gratification.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Y'all see this?
Mm-hmm.
Among them, which of them should be accounted the greatest? Stay right there.
Yeah.
Y'all see this?
Mm-hmm.
They argued about which one should be the greatest. They got the wrong attitude.
Yeah.
Come on, somebody.
Mm-hmm.
They sitting there, they've been with Jesus all this time. But yet they still have the wrong attitude about position. Come on, somebody.
That's good, sir.
And he said unto them, the kings of the Gentiles exercise lordship over them,
mm-hmm.
and they exercise authority upon them, are called benefactors. One of the definitions for that word benefactor is a title with honor.
Interesting.
Y'all see that? Because your title, when you say Tim Jones, that's just my name. But when you say Colonel Jones, uh-oh. Come on, somebody.
Yes, sir.
Huh?
That's good.
That ain't nobody but Paul.
Oh, no.
How you doing, General Paul?
Oh.
Immediately.
Right.
You stand to attention. Why? Because the title gives him honor.
Mm-hmm.
But God said, in my kingdom, oh my, a title don't give you honor.
Right.
Serving does.
Yes.
Oh, y'all, come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Are y'all with me?
Amen.
So you got to be a servant in God's kingdom. Come on now.
Amen.
Hallelujah. You know, when when our city manager comes around and we, oh, Chuck here. Don't we, Julie? But that's the way it is in the world. You know, that title gives you honor.
Yes, right.
Come on, somebody.
Yeah.
Y'all know when first sergeant come around, it's time to straighten up.
Yes, sir.
Major, captain, lieutenant comes around, it's time to straighten up.
Amen.
Amen. Why? Because the title to the name don't mean nothing without the title.
Amen.
But with God, it's the name that means something. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
And the name is Jesus.
Amen.
Oh, come on, somebody.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
Your title, you like it as I am. You like it as AG. It's just your title. It puts you in an authority. A title in ministry identifies your position.
Yes, sir.
When you receive a title, bishop just shows the position I'm in ministry. But watch this. I still need to have the attitude of a servant.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
And that's why you must serve before you're promoted. Oh, come on, sir.
Amen. That's right.
That's the high call. Watch this now. Can I keep going?
Amen.
Amen.
But ye shall not be so. But he that is greatest among you, let him be as the younger,
mm-hmm.
and he that is chief, as he that what?
Sir.
Watch this now. Watch this. For whether is greater, he that sitteth at meat, or he that serve?
Mm.
Is not he that sitteth at meat? But I am among you as he that
serve.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
You talking about Jesus.
Yes, sir.
The word of God made flesh coming down from heaven. And he said, I am among you to serve. Not reign and rule, but to serve.
Amen.
It is all right.
Yes.
Oh, man, I ain't even get it. I got some more time, y'all.
Yes.
He said, I am among you as one that serves. Watch this. Let me look this up. God is good, isn't he?
Amen.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Oh, he's awesome. Come with me. Woo, out of my mind. Come with me to John chapter 13. See, we got to look. See, if we look at Jesus, then you got the blueprint how to be promoted.
Amen.
Come on, somebody.
Amen.
You got the blueprint of how to walk this walk according to God's will.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. If you want to be in the perfect will of the Father, look at Jesus.
Amen.
Don't look to Bishop. Come on, somebody. Even though I'm your example, come on, somebody. Follow me as I follow Christ. I should be looking to Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
And I should be pointing you back to him.
Amen.
Oh, come on, somebody.
Yes. That's good, sir.
Let me see here. Let's start at verse 2. And supper being ended, the devil having now put into the heart of Judas Iscariot, Simon's son, to betray him. Jesus, knowing that the Father had given all things into his hands, and that he was come from God and went to God, he riseth from supper and laid aside his garments and took a towel and girded himself. Y'all see this?
Mm-hmm.
Says, after that, he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet.
Amen.
The Lord is washing the people that is under him feet. And to wipe them with the towel wherewith he was girded. So he took off his own garments to wipe their feet.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, sir. He didn't use their garments. He used his own garment. Come on, somebody. He took off his garments. Y'all looking at our Lord. Come on. Man, it just gets me excited about Jesus. Watch this. He says, Then cometh he to Simon Peter. And Peter said, Lord, doest thou wash my feet? Watch this. Jesus answered, said unto him, what I do thou knowest not now, but thou shalt know hereafter.
Mm-hmm.
Peter said unto him, thou shalt never wash my feet. Jesus answered him. See, Peter got that worldly attitude.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Y'all don't see it?
Yes, sir.
Wait a minute, wait a minute. You, the one in authority, how is it that you're washing my feet? He said, no, no, no. The one in authority need to do the serving.
Wow.
Oh, come on. There's no submission without serving.
Amen.
Come on. See, Jesus was set. There was a setup. If I serve you, you'll submit and serve me. Come on.
There you go. There you go.
See, husband, that's a nugget for your husband. Oh. If you serve, come on, they won't. If you subduing brings about rebellion. So Jesus didn't come in strong on them. He came and served them.
Yes.
And what they did was submit. Yeah. What does submit mean? Submit means to yield. What do yield mean? To give you the right to control.
Yeah.
Oh, come on.
Yes,
come on. I'm giving you the right.
Yeah.
I'm submitting to you. Because I know I don't submit to you just like driving. If you don't yield the right of way, you're going to cause an accident.
Yes. Yes.
So, Lord, if I don't yield to you to control my life, I'm going to have a lot of problems in my life.
Yes.
Ooh, come on, somebody. So I submit to you, and when I submit, I yield, I give you the right to control, therefore I serve.
Yes. Amen.
Ooh, come on.
That's good.
Is it all right?
It's all right, sir.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Watch, he said. He said, if I wash thee not, catch this, thou hast no part with me.
Mm-mm.
Keep going. Simon Peter said unto him, Lord, not my feet. Now, this is what it is. It's Peter. Here we go again. Here's Peter again. Not my feet only, but also my hands and my head. Come on, y'all. I wish I just would have been there to see how to look. Peter again. Don't you? He always got one of them Peters in ministry. I'll do it and just go to the extreme. Come on, but it's all good. Peter was the man. Jesus said unto him, He that is washed need not save to wash his feet, but is clean every whit. And ye are clean, but not all. I'm talking about Judas, keep going. For he knew who would betray him. Therefore said he, ye are not all clean.
Yeah.
Mm, that's another message.
Mm-hmm.
So after he washed their feet, watch this, and taken up his garment, and was set down again, he said unto them, Know ye what I have done to you? Ye call me Master and Lord, and ye say, well, for so am I. For so I am. If then your Lord and Master have washed your feet, ye also ought to wash one another's feet.
Amen.
Closer.
Cool.
Y'all with me?
Amen.
He said, you need to watch. This was this. For I have given you an example that ye should do as I have done to you.
Yes.
Wow. Amen.
Somebody help me up here.
Exactly.
He said, I'm the example.
Yes.
Here I am washing their feet. Now what makes you think, come on somebody, if he served them, then who am I not to serve you?
Amen.
Amen. Come on.
That's good, sir.
Amen.
That's good.
Because if I got the, see, if you don't have the right attitude, see, serving is an attitude.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. Yes. Because I can serve you not willingly.
Yeah.
Ooh, come on.
Mm.
Oh, y'all better.
Mm.
Come on, somebody.
Come on now.
I can serve you not willingly. Why? Because how you treat me.
Mm.
But if I got the attitude of God, oh my, if I got the attitude of God, doesn't matter how you treat me.
That's right.
Yeah. That's right.
Come on, somebody. That's how you can determine whether you got the right attitude. Is it attitude or is it, come on, altitude?
Come on now.
Huh?
Yeah.
Come on, somebody.
Come on.
And so what it is, amen, it will determine when somebody treats you, Lord, am I serving? Well, that will determine how you're treated.
Amen.
Then your response to being treated wrong. Come on, somebody. Because if a lot of people watch this now, if you treat me wrong, then I'll serve you.
Mm-hmm.
but not willingly. Oh, come on, somebody. And the Bible says you be willing and obedient. So I'm going to be obedient, but not willingly. I'll serve you, but not willingly. I'm going to fix your food, but I ain't willingly doing it. Come on, y'all. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Y'all, come on, somebody. Come on. Come on. Will somebody take out, the trash? You've been there before. Huh? You've done things not willingly. Come on, somebody. Because the way you were treated. Are y'all with me? And Jesus said, I've given you an example. And then he says, verily, verily, I say unto you, the servant is no greater than his Lord, neither he that is sent greater than he that sent him.
Wow. Huh.
Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Came to serve.
Amen.
Huh? And before you can be promoted in a position of authority, come on, somebody. You must learn how to serve.
Amen.
And whatever you put your hands to do,
amen.
Do it with all your might. See, I like what D.D. said the other day. He said, see, we was talking about serving. A self-serving person will say, well, that's not my auxiliary.
That's good, sir.
That's self-serving. Well, what I got to do with it? It's not me. I ain't getting no accolades for that.
Oh, wow.
I need Bishop to get his pom-poms out for me.
Wow.
Cheer for me. I need him to see me. But a servant is what you need done. Let's do it. And guess what? I'm going to go the extra mile. Because Jesus said, if somebody tell you to go one, go two.
Yeah.
Come on, somebody. If they give you their cloak, give them what?
Your coat.
Your coat also.
Huh? Give them, go the extra. You know what he said? Go the extra mile. So when you're helping someone serve, you need to go the extra mile even in their auxiliary.
Yeah. Amen.
This attitude. Somebody, come on, somebody. And God wants us to change our attitude. Come on. To serve. Stop thinking about titles, because titles are flattery. That's what the scripture says.
Yes.
Flattery titles. But a servant is honored. Jesus didn't say to the ones he gave five talents, two talents, and one talent, he didn't say, thou good and faithful apostle, thou good and faithful prophet, thou good and faithful evangelist, thou good and faithful teacher, thou good and faithful pastor. Did he say that? He said, thou good and faithful servant.
Yes. Amen.
Man, yeah. He said, thou good and faithful servant. Are you a faithful servant?
Amen.
We must learn how to serve before we are promoted.
Amen.
Are y'all with me?
Yes, sir.
Go with me to. Let's go to the word. David was a man after God's own heart.
Amen.
God will call. Let's just go to the word. Go to 1 Samuel. Let's see. Is this all right?
It's all right, sir.
Let's go to. We know the story. God's Samuel sitting there mourning over Saul. And God said, how long will you mourn for Saul?
Come on, sir. Tell me about it.
But if I go back, I'm going to go back and we got to go back and look at Samuel. Samuel was a servant.
Yes, he was.
Before he was promoted. But we're going to go back. But watch this. Samuel comes. Think about if Samuel would have answered the call of God, there would be no David. Come on. But Samuel had to answer the call. He answered the call and then he went to anoint David. And so he went looking. Watch this. He went looking and God said, I provided me a king. Y'all with me?
Amen.
He said, I provided me a king. And then in Samuel 16, 1 Samuel 16, and verse 13, watch this. Then Samuel took the horn of oil and anointed him in the midst of what? And the Spirit of the Lord came upon David from that day, what? And Samuel rose up and went to where? The Spirit of the Lord came upon David. David was anointed king then, but he did not step into the king office. He had to go through, he had to serve first. Oh, somebody help me. I love about this David. God said David was a man after my own heart. And see, watch this. Just because, see, many a times God called you, and this is what happened to a lot of us. We prematurely get into an office. We put ourselves into an office prematurely, and we're not ready for it.
Amen.
Amen.
Because we had an intuitive witness. In other words, that silence, something said, the Bible said the Spirit bears witness with our spirit that we are the children of God. So the Spirit spoke to you and said, you're called to preach. Don't necessarily mean you need to step out and start preaching.
That's right.
Come on, somebody. Because when there's an intuitive witness, come on. I knew that I was called to preach, but there has to be a confirmed witness. Watch this. You know, I wrote this word down. Watch this. Intuitive. A witness, watch this. Having the ability to know or understand things without any proof or evidence. You just heard you was called. You don't have no evidence.
That's good, sir.
Come on. That's an intuitive witness.
Yes, sir.
You got, I heard, guys. I heard. How many folks you heard? I'm a preacher. I'm a pastor. I'm a... Who told you that? Well, God told you that, but how was it confirmed? Have you served anywhere? See, this is why people need this type of teaching.
Yes, sir.
I'm called. You've been saved 2 weeks. I'm an apostle. I'm a prophet.
I'm anointed. I've heard that. I'm anointed.
Well, David was anointed.
Yes, sir.
He was anointed without character. Oh, come on, somebody. See, you all are anointed. Come on. That's true. I was anointed when I first got saved. I got filled with the Holy Spirit. Man, I was anointed and God was using me. Don't mean I was Pastor Tim.
Right.
Even though, watch this now, the first day I got saved, Elder Paul, I'm going to write about it. The first day I got saved, Elder Fedoria came to me and said, man, God called you to preach the gospel. The first day. That don't mean, oh, he did? No, let me get out here and start preaching it. And then when he spoke that, you know, it went over my head, but I started feeling that intuitive witness. The Holy Spirit bear witness with my spirit that I was called to preach.
Amen.
Are y'all with me? But I also needed a confirmed witness. A confirmed witness, watch this. Confirmation, to state or show that it is true and correct.
Amen.
Are y'all with me?
Amen.
He's somebody that confirms it. He confirms it by stating it. Amen. You are called. But opposite of my spirit, you're called to be a pastor.
Amen.
It agrees in your spirit. Why? Because God gave you an intuitive witness. The Holy Ghost is your intuitive witness. Then you got a prophet coming to confirm that thing.
Right. Amen.
Huh? Then there's the demonstration witness. Come on. The show, you got to show some signs and wonders and power. Amen. God got to be working through your life. Come on, somebody.
Come on now. Amen.
People need to see the Lord working in your life.
Amen.
Then you have the audible witness. When, like Paul got knocked off his horse. People heard lights. They just heard a noise. But Paul heard the voice of God. Oh, somebody help me.
Amen.
If Jesus had to go through this process, what make you think you don't have to? Come on, somebody. The Bible says that there are three that bear record in heaven. The Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost. And these three are what? That word record means witness or testify.
Amen.
When Jesus came to the earth at his baptism, oh, y'all better help me. I don't have the time to go there. But at his baptism, John the Baptist, amen, he knew. God, he had an intuitive witness. That's him. Because in Matthew, he said, I need to be baptized of you.
Amen.
But I need confirmation that you are who you say.
Yes.
And it's the Holy Ghost that bears witness to the Word. Amen. So here we have the Word and the Holy Ghost, which is in John, because God had anointed Jesus with the Holy Ghost, the scripture says. When did Jesus get anointed? Jesus, Savior, Christ, Messiah, or anointed? When did God anoint Jesus? When he got baptized.
Yeah.
And Jesus Christ. Watch this. John said, I didn't know who he was in John chapter 1. He said, but in Matthew, he had an intuitive witness that it was him. But I need confirmation that it's him. And God said, watch this. Here's the witness to his confession. Here's the witness to my confession. Watch this.
Wow.
Because God said, this is my beloved son. That was his confession.
Yes. Wow.
In whom I am well pleased. But I need to have a witness to my.
Yeah.
Yeah. Boy, y'all want to get this thing, man. God said, I need to have a witness to my own confession.
Yeah.
Wow. Because out of the mouth of two or three witnesses, let every word be established. So we have God a witness, we have the Holy Ghost a witness, and we have Jesus a witness.
Yeah.
Whoops. Said, whom you baptize, and when you see the Spirit descend like a dove upon him, that is he that shall baptize with fire and the Holy Ghost. John baptized Jesus. He had an intuitive witness. And when he baptized Jesus, Jesus came up out of the water. John said, I bear record. I saw the Holy Ghost descend like a dove upon him, and I bear record that this is the Son of God. Why? Because God confessed it and I confirmed it.
Yeah. Amen.
Okay.
Amen.
And Jesus, the scriptures submitted, when he was a boy, he grew in grace.
Mm-hmm.
But he submitted to his father and mother.
Amen.
That's good.
Y'all with me?
That's good, sir.
You must serve before you step into your calling. And just because you get anointed, see, David got anointed that day.
Mm-hmm.
Don't mean you just go out and start. See, that's why churches are dropping like flies. Huh? You got to make sure God has graced you. See, Paul, man, I'm all over the place. I know, but Paul, amen, I found out he was a year in Jerusalem. He was a year in Antioch, I'm sorry. And then they sent them to Jerusalem, came back from Jerusalem, him and Barnabas, and then the Holy Ghost said, separate me, Paul and Barnabas, into the ministry, into the work. He said, unto the work I've called them to. Separate me, Paul and Barnabas. And so Paul had to serve before he was released.
Amen.
Yes.
You got to serve before you start. Let's look at it. You had to come back Sunday and get the rest of this. If God say the same.
Amen.
Then Samuel took the horn of oil and anointed him in the midst of his brethren. And the Spirit of the Lord came upon David from that day forward. So Samuel rose up and went to Ramah. But the Spirit of the Lord departed from Saul. Y'all see this? And an evil spirit from the Lord troubled him. Saul's servant said unto him, behold, now the evil spirit from God troubleth thee. Let our Lord now command thy servant, which are before thee, to seek out a man who is a cunning player on a harp. And it shall come to pass, when the evil spirit from God is upon thee, he shall play with his hands, and thou shalt be well.
Wow.
Y'all with this? And Saul said to his servant, provide now a man that can play well and bring him to me. Then answered one servant and said, behold, I have seen the son of Jesse, the Bethlehemite, that he is a cunning player and a mighty man, a mighty valiant man. Y'all see this? A man of war, a prudent and prudent in matters, and comely person, and the Lord is with them. Wherefore Saul sent messengers unto Jesse and said, send David thy son, which is with the sheep. And Jesse took an ass laden with bread and a bottle of wine and a kid and sent them by David his son unto Saul. And David came to Saul and stood before him, and he loved him greatly. And he came and he became his what? David became his armor bearer. Y'all with me? Amen. Now watch it. Then Goliath come. We know the story about Goliath, to make a long story short. Jump over to 17. David, amen, he's Saul's armor bearer. He's playing. He's anointed to play. Driving spirits, that evil spirit away. David's an anointed man. He's anointed king. But he hasn't stepped into the office yet. Mm-hmm. Come on, somebody. Mm-hmm. You'll do what God has called you to do before you step into the position. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I went from singing to a singing preacher. Mm-hmm. Huh? Mm-hmm. God is a good God. Yes, he is. How many of you know God is a good God? He's good in the valley, good in the... Come here. I just started operating in it, you know. Right. I couldn't even, it was like every time I sing it, I wind up preaching. Mm-hmm. Come on, somebody. Yep. So David was anointed. He was already operating. He already had the attributes. Mm-hmm. He just needed to serve first.
Amen.
Come on, watch this. Here go Goliath about to take David. David about to fight Goliath, and Saul is trying to give David his armor. And I'm going to end it with this. Go to 17 and 32. Watch what David said to Saul. And David said to Saul, let not my heart fail because of him. Talk about Goliath. By what?
Servant.
Will go and fight with this Philistine. He said out of his own mouth, thy what? Servant, but anointed king. Is that good stuff? He knew he was anointed king because Samuel anointed him. But here he is saying, thy servant.
That's right.
Huh? He has the attitude, the right attitude. He's a man after God's own heart. This is a good example of the right attitude of serving. He said, thy servant. Watch this now, watch this. He says, and Saul said to David, thou art not able to go against the Philistine and fight with him, for thou art but a youth, and a man of war, and he a man of war from his youth. And David said unto Saul, thy servant kept his father's sheep. And there came a bear and took a lamb out of the flock, and I went out after him and smote him and delivered it out of his mouth. And when he arose against me, I caught him by his beard and smote him and slew him. Thy servant, oh, y'all see this? Amen. Thy servant slew both the lion and the bear, and this uncircumcised Philistine shall be as one of them, seeing he hath defied the armies of the living God. He said, look, I've got experience. Okay. Huh? See, while you're, boy, y'all get this thing. While you're serving, Bree, you also get experience.
Yeah.
Huh? You get more mature to where you can deal with a giant. Because if he had not had the lion and the bear, he wouldn't have dealt with the giant.
Amen.
Ooh, come on, somebody.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. And God said, and watch this, God is elevating him while he's serving.
Yes,
amen. Amen.
Y'all see this? He dealt with the lion and the bear. Oh my, lions, tigers, and bears. Oh my, David is experiencing things. Are y'all with me? But as he he did defeat the lion and the bear, God is elevating, preparing him for his position. And you need preparation for your position. Come on, somebody. And David is being prepared for his position. He's prepared to deal with the giant. Why? Because of my past experience with God. He delivered me from that. He delivered me from that. Surely he can deliver me from this giant while I'm still serving.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. He could have easily been boasted. I'm anointed. Really, I'm supposed to be in your position. Oh, come on. You got folks anointed, and they're supposed to be in the preacher's position. You ain't walked in them shoes. Do you know what it took to get here? But all of a sudden, because you can preach a little bit, you got a little revelation or something, and you can use big words, and you intellect, and you think you called to get up in this position, and you haven't defeated nothing in your life.
That's good, sir.
Somebody help me. You just can't get up here. You want to jump to the stage and not take the steps to the stage.
Wow, sir. That's good.
All of a sudden, I'm anointed. I'm more anointed than you. But David knew he was anointed, but he kept the attitude of a servant.
Amen.
Amen.
And God
Amen.
Kept elevating him.
Yes.
Kept elevating. Now watch this. Saul was a crooked preacher. And he tried to give David his armor that he wasn't even practicing what he was preaching.
Man.
You take my armor and you don't even use it.
That's good.
Huh? And David said, I don't have no experience with this. Mm-hmm. God delivered me with this sling. I got experience with this.
Yeah.
Oh, come on, somebody. If it ain't working for you, I don't need to use that. I'll still serve you, but I don't have to use what you're using.
Amen.
Oh, come on. Wow. Yeah, come on, somebody.
Wow.
Come on, somebody. Come on. See, he's got the right attitude. Just because your preacher might be in left field, but you need to serve till God release.
Yes.
Because if your attitude is not right, you will stay up under that crooked preacher until you change your attitude.
That's good, sir.
Oh, somebody help me. You will stay up under that until you change your attitude. Yep. Let me serve you right. No matter if you're not practicing what you preach, God will release me from it. But I'm going to serve you.
Amen.
Okay.
That's good, sir.
It is all right.
Yes. All right.
Now watch this. Come with me. Now, David done slew the giant. Here's my closing. David done slew the giant.
Mm-hmm.
He come back and Saul done promoted him. Huh? Mm. Not knowing that he taking your place. You can't promote him enough. Because you just setting him up to take your position. But watch this. Can I help you? Go to 18 of Samuel. Verse 6, the attitude. Somebody say attitude.
Attitude.
You got to have the right attitude.
Yes.
And when you have the right attitude, God will elevate you. The Bible said Jesus took upon himself the form of a servant.
Amen.
Who thought it not robbery to be equal with God. But he took upon himself the form of a servant. Had the right attitude. Persecuted. Falsely accused. Afflicted. Come on, somebody. But yet served. Oh, come on, somebody. You know what when it's determined when you're a good server? When you're going through hell. Huh?
Amen.
What's your attitude then?
Amen.
Is it self-gratified? Oh, woe with me. I can't do it no more. Well, God said, no, you need to still serve.
Yeah.
You need to still serve. Watch this. Watch this. 6:18-6. I'm going to go to 11. Watch it. And it came to pass that as they came, when David was returned from the slaughter of the Philistine, that the women came out of all the cities of Israel. Y'all see it? Singing, dancing to meet King Saul. Y'all see this?
Mm-hmm.
With tablets, with joy, with instruments of music. What did I say? Demonstration, witness.
Mm-hmm.
And the women answered one another and they played and said, Saul has slain his 1,000, but David his 10,000.
Wow.
God began to demonstrate that demonstration witness. It began to, the people began to see the anointed on him. Mm. Oh, come on, somebody. Wait a minute, man, this brother, I think it's him. Watch this, keep going. And Saul was very what?
Wow.
Don't you know people don't get mad with the anointing? They ain't mad with you, they mad with that anointing on your life. Yeah. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Oh, man, God, just using that sister. Watch this. And the saying displeased him. And he said, they have ascribed unto David 10,000, and to me they have ascribed but 1,000. And what can he have more but the kingdom?
Y'all see this?
And Saul eyed David from that day and forward. You see that? He had his eyes on him now. I got my eye on you now. People like you more than me. I'm watching you. I'm watching you now. Come on, somebody. I gotta get this little my wife sleepy. Watch this. I got my eye on you. Everybody looking at you now. And you know, people, I've experienced this. People get mad with you.
Yep.
Yes.
Yes.
Especially when folk want to hear you more.
Mm, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. It done happened to me a lot of times. Yeah, sit down. You, sit down. Mm-hmm. Let that brother get up and preach. But see, a true servant, he's comfortable in his own skin.
That's right. Yeah.
Come on. I'm not here to please you. I'm here to please the Father.
Yes.
Come on, somebody. So when you try to imitate, you become intimidated. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah.
Come on now.
Come on, somebody.
Yeah.
When you try to imitate, you preach with fear.
Mm-hmm.
Because you think you might mess up because you try to imitate somebody else.
That's it. Mm-hmm.
So you get intimidated by the one you try to imitate.
Mm-hmm.
Huh? When I try to imitate you, I'm intimidated by you.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Oh, come on, somebody.
That's good.
So I don't need to intimidate anybody. Come on, somebody. I just need to be like him.
That's
and
right.
Let him use me. He don't need two Tims. He don't need two Johnnies. He don't need two Pauls. He need to use me.
Right.
Come on, somebody. Doesn't matter if you jump up and say amen. Long as I'm doing the will of the Father.
Amen.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. Come on. We got too much competition in the pulpit.
Yes, sir.
Come on, somebody. Let him use you. Watch this, watch this. Well, man, I know Dante there. And it came to pass on the morrow that watch this, that the evil spirit from God came upon Saul. And he prophesied in the midst of the house. Here he is prophesying with an evil spirit on him. Look at it, y'all see that?
Mm-hmm.
And David played with his hand, and as the other times, and there was a javelin in Saul's hand. Keep going. And Saul cast the javelin, for he said, I will smite David, even to the wall with it. And David avoided out of his presence twice. Y'all see that?
Yes, sir, twice.
But watch this. David came back and served him.
Yes.
Wow.
Amen.
And he knew Saul was out to get him.
That takes guts.
In spite of it.
Amen.
That's the heart of a servant.
Yes.
No matter how he was treated, he still served him.
Mm-hmm.
He had the right attitude. Is this helping anybody?
Yes. Amen.
He still served him no matter how Saul treated him. And even in Saul's death, they came back and told David, Saul is dead. And the guy came back, it was a Dolomite, wasn't it? It was an Edomite. What came back and said, David's dead.
Saul is dead.
Well, whoever?
Malachi.
Some kind of eye. Came back and told him. Praise God. I'm a man. Amen. Praise God. Came back told him that David is dead.
Saul
is dead. Says Saul is dead. And he was glorified in that. Thought David was going to be happy about it. And David said, did you not know? That was God's anointing.
Exactly.
And you hear glorified in that. I served that man. David God delivered Saul in David's hand various times, and David said, ain't touching. I'm not touching God. I'm not touching. See, when you leave, when God release you from a ministry, don't touch that man of God.
That's right.
Don't touch.
That's right.
Oh boy, I'm trying to help somebody. Yeah, right. When God release you from a ministry, don't put your mouth on them because God released you from it.
Amen.
Don't touch him because now you're holding your blessing up.
No.
You're holding up your promotion.
Yeah.
And David knew, said, even though God delivered me in your, in, delivered you into my hand, I still won't touch you.
Yes,
I'm still willing to serve.
Yes,
amen. Amen.
He ran from him, hiding in caves, yet still willing to serve him.
Yeah.
Wow. He ran from a mother, hiding in caves, yet willing to serve.
Yes. Amen.
That's why God said David is a man after my own heart.
Yes.
Because he has the right attitude.
Yes, sir.
And when it was time for David to be promoted, all the people came. God is with you. The anointing is on your life. We want to serve you.
Amen.
We want you to be our king.
Amen.
Because you got the right attitude.
Amen.
We know you will serve us, so therefore we submit to your authority.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
And when you got a preacher that's willing to serve the people the word, without any pretense or any motives behind it, when he's willing to serve you freely, you should want to submit to that authority.
Yes.
Amen.
And serve the man of God back.
Amen.
See, when you serve, then honor comes.
Amen.
Amen.
Give honor where honor is due. Where honor is due,
yes,
is due to the one that serves.
Yes. Amen.
Come on, somebody, give God praise. You give honor where honor is due. You give honor where honor is due. And when you see a man submitted to God, laboring for God, then you submit to that. But let me tell you something. Everybody got to go through that process before you're promoted. Progress, process, then you have the success. But you got to go through it, man. You got to serve. Also, and it doesn't matter how you're being treated. You got to serve the Father. Please the Father. Whatever you put your hands to do, do it with all your might.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Give God praise.